Right, Battletech, a game of armored combat for the Sega Mega Drive by Malibu Interactives, the division of Malibu Comics Entertainment Inc. Sorry, I don't know what I'm doing. What the? Are we enough with the logos? That's possibly rendered and then quite nicely re-rendered into 2D. This is nice. I'm loving the intro. It looks like sort of game. Oh yeah, better and better. This is nice. Battletech. Is that going to be a mech? Oh, I like the explosions. Slight priority issues there, falling behind the tanks, but hey, a technicality, and we don't really care. That's beautiful. It looks like they're rendered, like 3D rendered, but then properly touched up in pixel art with a nice limited palette, you know, rather than all that horrible dithering that you get. Unless they're just really well hand drawn, which I very much doubt. No, they are 3D rendered. That boy had far too many frames of animation. Battletech. I love it when the developer does like a deep movie voice and goes, Battletech, a game of armored combat. I think Naughty Dog did it loads in like the thingy games, the Crash games. A Naughty Dog production, all this. It's like, really? We can tell that you're just like a normal person. You haven't got like the deep Hollywood voice, really. Do you know what I mean? But I love it. I love it when they try to do that. This is cool. This is a mech game, right? Let's press start to play as it suggests. I like the look of this. I haven't seen a game like this on the Mega Drive. But that might be because I probably just should have. Look at him. Battletech. I can't get over that. That's so cool. Right. That's just one player start. As it was meant to be played. Your first mission takes place on the planet. Oh, really? I've got make-up names for planets. Okay. PPC. Oh, cool. It's got loads of speech.
Machine gun. Missile.
Miffle.
Machine gun.
Machine gun.
PPC.
PPC. Okay, I'm going with the PPC. Sorry, it's the compression, I know. Yeah, we know this. No, come on. We don't like it when it starts taking us on a little guided tour of the front end because we're pressing the wrong button. Clearly, the B button was back. But I always find the B button is the kind of central button. Yeah, I've all. Oh, this is nice to play. I was fine. The B button is central. He's shooting at me, whoever he is. But look at him. What's going on there? I want to jump over the wall. Oops. I just did something. Right, let's find out what things do. That.
Overcharging.
Ah, plane shooting at me. Ah, I'm freaking out. A mech freaking out. That's what a mech freaking out looks like. Yeah, I always find that, really, I'm not being murdered by a little tiny dude. Oh, this is good. It's got like an element of, is it Desert Strike to it? Just because of the...
Enemy mech approaching.
Just because of the isometrics, really. Oh, it's a mech. Have that. Oh no, don't turn around. Kill him. Come on, you can batter him. You're like twice his size. Take him out. What are you playing at? Just keep shooting him.
Overheating.
Jeez, that took way more effort than it probably should have. Ah, just stood on an explosion. Oh, I like this. This is good. Look at that animation, that's ace. Clearly 3D rendered, but it's not the 3D rendering that impresses me. It's the pixel popping afterwards, the touching ups, the tidying ups. Look how tidy a job that is. Too often with 3D render stuff, you'd find they just left it as it rendered, but in, I don't know, 8 colours or whatever they were using for the sprites. And as a result of that, what you get is really fuzzy, horrible 3D render stuff. Rise of the Robots, I'm